Bienvenidos clase. Hoy vamos a continuar nuestra discusión sobre el mundo hispano. Yesterday, in the video, I have some background music playing on my Alexa, and I didn't realize how well that would pick up on the microphone. I apologize. I'm not going to go back and re-record the video because I kind of like that music, and it's a little bit groovy. It gives you something to listen to while you're working. But yeah, so I've turned the music off for this one. So en el mundo hispano, pues, without music, vamos a ver un video y ustedes van a responder a las preguntas en la página 27, ¿no? So I can't bring up page 27 and show the video at the same time. So I want you to open your books to page 27 and where it says, a ver el video. A ver el video. A ver el video. And I want you guys to answer these questions. So I'm going to play the video once, and then I want you to go back and replay it and watch again and watch as many times as you need to pick up on all these. This is develop your listening skills as well. Muy bien, vamos a ver.
¿Dónde son los hispanos?
Soy de Uruguay.
Soy de España.
Soy peruano.
Soy argentino.
Hola, yo soy de Guatemala.
Soy de México.
Hay 21 países diferentes donde el español es el idioma oficial.
Soy de Venezuela.
Soy de Colombia.
Soy cubano.
Soy ecuatoriana.
Estos países tienen mucha historia y cultura en común. Sin embargo, cada uno tiene sus características específicas. Esto se puede ver, por ejemplo, en los saludos.
Hola, hola, encantada.
Un placer.
En Perú, los amigos se saludan con un beso en la mejilla.
Hola, Sofía.
Daniel, ¿qué tal?
Muy bien, gracias.
En España, los amigos se saludan con dos besos.
Hola, Carmen.
Hola.
En cualquier país, los viejos amigos se saludan con un abrazo. El contacto físico es muy importante. En el trabajo, entre amigos.
¿Cómo estás?
Bien.
Y con miembros de la familia.
Hombre.
Bienvenido al mundo hispano.
Muy bien, so go back and watch that again if you need to, if you don't have all the answers. But otherwise, we're going to go ahead and answer these questions. So the countries mentioned in the video, I'm just going to read them out. We have Argentina, Colombia, Ecuador, Guatemala, España, México, Perú, Uruguay, Venezuela. El español es el idioma oficial en 21 países. 21 países. Los países del mundo hispano tienen mucha historia y cultura en común. En España, los amigos se saludan con dos besos y en Perú con un beso. ¿Cómo se saludan los viejos amigos? Con un abrazo. Muy bien, pues a ver, vamos a continuar. ¿Y cómo se deletra? Pues hay 21 países donde se habla español. I know in the previous class I said there were 22, but I was including Puerto Rico, which of course is not a country as we know. It's a Commonwealth of the United States. ¿Cuántas letras hay en el alfabeto español? Well, we have 26 in English, right? So we have 26 in Spanish. Incorrect. There are actually 27 letters in the Spanish alphabet, and we're going to find out exactly what they are. Aquí vamos. Ustedes, so repeat after me. A. B. C. D. E. F. G. H. I. J. K. L. And I should actually mention that in the book, this is on page 15, right? L. M. N. Enye. 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 Right? So it's like saying N. Ye. Enye. O. P. Q. R. S. T. U. V. V doble, o doble V. I learned it as doble V. The book has it as V doble. Either one is fine. Equis. Ye. The book has it as ye. I learned it as I griega. I griega. So I'll probably say I griega instead of ye. N I zeta. Right? Let's go over it again. A. B. C. D. E. F. G. H. I. J. K. L. M. N. Enye. O. P. Q. R. S. T. U. V. Double V. X, Y, Z. Interestingly enough, there were actually used to be more letters in the Spanish alphabet when I learned it. There was the Che was a letter, Ye was a letter, and R, double R, which is rolled. R used to be a letter as well, and they are no longer letters. The Real Academia Española eliminated them as letters. Saying that they were not necessary for the alphabet. So there you go. Muy bien. Pues, ¿cómo se escribe Ana? So I want you to pause the video and go over how you would and spell Ana. Oso. Madrid. España. Remember, there's a little tilde over that. There's an accent. Quince. Yucatán. Zanahoria. Muy bien. Pues vamos a continuar. 1.14. I'm going to spell out some places for you. And you guys are going to tell me, you're going to write it down as I go, right? And see if you get the spelling correct. Número uno. B. A. R. R. A. N. Q. U. I. L. L. A. And what is that? That's Barranquilla. Barranquilla. Una ciudad en Colombia cuya residente más famosa es Shakira. Shakira mentions Barranquilla sometimes in her music. Número dos. A. R. E. Q. U. I. P. A. Esto es Arequipa. In southern Peru. Número tres. V. E. R. A. C. R. U. Z. Esto es Veracruz. City in Mexico, in the Gulf of Mexico. Cuatro. B. O. G. O. T. A. Bogotá. There's an acento on that. Bogotá, the capital of Colombia. Cinco. S. A. N. T. E. A. G. O. Esto es Santiago. Santiago, the capital of Chile. Número seis. Q. U. E. R. E. T. A. R. O. Esto es Querétaro. Querétaro city, just north of Mexico City, which is really beautiful. If you ever have the chance to go, do go. Muy bien, pues. 114. Oh, we already did that. There's not a lot of practicing we can do with the alphabet. It's one of those things that it's, you know, not easy to practice. Just keep running through it in your head, right? So we're going to do a repaso de este capítulo because we are at the end of the chapter and you do have a chapter quiz coming up tomorrow. So I want you to write, without looking at your book, los meses, los días y las estaciones. The months, the days, and the seasons. Pause the video now. Muy bien, los meses. Tenemos enero, febrero, marzo, abril, mayo, junio, julio, agosto, septiembre, octubre, noviembre, diciembre. Los días. Lunes, martes, Miércoles, accent on the E. Jueves, viernes, sábado, accent on the first day. Domingo, estaciones. Invierno, primavera, verano, otoño. Write the masculine forms of the following. Pause the video now. Okay, so ambiciosa becomes ambicioso. Inteligente, same masculine form, it doesn't change. Optimista, not optimisto, it actually doesn't change, it's optimista. Masculine or feminine. Puntual, it doesn't change, it's puntual. Write the plural of the following. Pause the video now. Muy bien, ambiciosas, inteligentes, optimistas, puntuales. So you're seeing a pattern. If it ends in a vowel, just add an S. If it ends in a consonant, add an ES. There are a few exceptions to that, but very few exceptions. For example, with words that end in Z, like luz, light, luces, it changes to a C, right? And that's for pronunciation reasons. Las formas de ser. Pause the video now. Yo soy, tú eres, él, ella, usted es, nosotros somos, vosotros sois, ellos, ellas, ustedes son. Muy bien. And that's it, guys. There's one activity you can do in the textbook that's in the textbook in the workbook that's left. And it is activity 13, 113. Super easy. It'll take you like 2 seconds to do this. So I'm going to link to you a few videos that also go over the alphabet. Just in case you want some other input, that's fine. And down below in the comments, if I can find any practice online, I will put it there. Other than that, esto fue excelente. No, good luck on the quiz tomorrow. And remember, after the quiz, do the short class, the introduction to, I'm not quite sure wherever we're going next. If I have the calendar, it's the introduction to Puerto Rico, right? So be sure to watch that video after you finish the quiz. That's it for today. Nos vemos. Ciao.